Hi, I'm Stew3D, and on this stream and subsequent YouTube upload, it's going to be a little bit of a rant about something me and my mate Scazius have talked about as of late, and that is, why are there no upgradable laptops? I mean, yeah, sure, yes, you can get laptops where you can upgrade the RAM, the hard drive in, but I'm talking about processor, graphics. These companies are all about reducing, they're going on about, we need to reduce e-waste. There's big landfill sites in China full of old computers and stuff like that. All we're doing is contributing more to it. I mean, I've just bought this HP Omen gaming laptop. It was an £800 laptop, so whilst it's not the most expensive laptop in the world, it certainly wasn't cheap. And, I realistically have got, what, a couple of 3 years out of it before it won't be able to run the latest games properly. And at that point, I'm then forced to go out and buy a whole new gaming laptop, which it does seem like a bit of a waste because apart from the GPU, at that point, the graphics card will really be the only thing that really needs to be updated. I mean, supposedly Nvidia did bring out an MXM slot, which allowed you to upgrade your graphics cards at a later on date, but I don't think it caught on. But I mean, realistically, how awesome would it be? You buy your £800 laptop, you're happy with the screen and everything else. But you got the 1050 because at the time that was all you could afford. However, in a couple of few 3 months' time, you're a bit more flush, and you can go out and say get a 1070 upgrade for it. Open it up, pull a little card out, and shove a 1070 in it. How awesome would that be? I mean, it's just it boggles mind really because I've my mate Skaz, he has just bought an old, he calls it the burn PC, and literally it was dirt cheap old ex-business PC. It has an Intel Core i5 2400 in it, and he bought it for, well, peanuts. I believe total cost, because he's gone and stuck an Nvidia 1050 Ti in it, low profile. And I think the total cost, he keeps saying to me, is around about £350. Now, the processors haven't really changed that much in a few years. That 2400 is now only just becoming a bit long in the tooth. Bear with me a second. Let me just try and fast travel because I can't seem to climb onto my ship for whatever reason. So, yes, bear with me. Bear with. There we go. So yeah, but yeah, the processors really haven't come on a massive way in the last few years. As I said, he's running a second generation Core i5, and it's still able to keep up with, some of the latest generation chips, especially in gaming. Obviously, in video encoding performance and stuff, it's not going to be quite as good. But at the end of the day, the fact is, he's been able to take an ancient desktop computer, an ex-business thing that he's bought for, very little money, shove a 1050 Ti in it for, again, very little money, and he has got a device now which is more powerful than a PlayStation 4, and probably as powerful as a PlayStation 4 Pro. He can keep up with, most of the demanding games. He was running benchmarks on the new Doom game and everything else, and it just ate it up for breakfast. It was brilliant. I mean, why aren't there upgrades for laptops? I mean, how awesome would it be? You got your, I don't know, second, you got your third or fourth generation Core i5, i7 laptop, which, I don't know, it's got an integrated card because it was more of a business laptop at the time, but that's what you had. But now you want to play games on it. just slot in a little, take the bottom off, slot in a card, be able to play games. How awesome would that be? I mean, for me, as I said, I'm lucky in the case that when I do have to upgrade this laptop in a cup in a few couple of 3 years' time to be able to play the latest games, my daughter will be at the age where she'll need a laptop for school, so this will get passed down to her, so won't end up going to waste, thank God. Especially with Windows laptops, purely because they don't hold their value. I mean, I paid £800 for this, and I can guarantee you in a year's time, I'd be lucky to get 200 for it if I was to flog it on eBay. Whereas my old Mac, I bought an old white MacBook a good few years ago, and I had that for about 6 or 7 years and was still able to sell it for 250 quid, purely because the Apple seems to hold its value. And as I said, if you could upgrade your laptops, you wouldn't be throwing as many into landfill. And it's just, I mean, at the end of the day, the graphics are gonna go give out on this way with playing the latest games way before the processor, and I don't know, it just seems like a massive waste. I know why. It's purely because, oh yeah, well, what HP would rather I go and shove buy a whole new 800 quid laptop instead of actually just shoving a 200 quid graphics card in. But surely there should be some, I don't know, some government department somewhere saying, look, we've got to reduce e-waste, we're it's becoming a big problem, we can't recycle these things. Obviously, they're making a big song and dance about trying to melt these things down and extract like the gold and the precious metals back out of them. But if you could upgrade it, you wouldn't be throwing it in the bin. I mean, I know for a fact that if I could upgrade this and shove a new graphics card in it in a couple of years' time, I would certainly do that. It'd make, it wouldn't go to waste. It's a decent little laptop. And I mean, at the moment, it is playing the latest games at fairly decent quality settings. Obviously, not the best quality settings, but fairly decent. Bear with me a second. Let me just. I don't know what I'll do with the gun. Wee-hee! There we go. I just blew the ship up. But yeah, I'm able to play the latest games with fairly decent settings. Yeah, a couple of exceptions. Forza Horizon 3 being one of them. But at the end of the day, I could, if I could have upgraded the graphics card in this, at the moment you have the choice of, do I spend £800 on a budget model like what I've got? Do I then spend £300 more to get a, or £200 to £300 more to get a Ti? Do I then spend another £400 to £500 more to get a 1060? Do I then spend, £700 to £800 more to get a 1070? And as again, in one of my conversations with Skaz, we've discussed this at length. I could have bought the 1070 model of the HP laptop with the 17-inch screen, and it had a 1070 and an i7 in it. But there could be a game come out tomorrow which will bring a 1070 to its knees, and then at that point, you feel like you've wasted the 1400 quid on the machine, which you now have to start turning settings down on. At least with this, I had my ex I knew my expectations. It's an 800 quid computer, which isn't cheap, but is still more than capable. But yeah, it's just a shame. It just seems like a waste that, in a few years' time, if I didn't have, a couple, or I would say I'm going to get, what, 2, maybe 3 years of decent gaming out of this before I'm realistically going to have to upgrade. I mean, the one thing that's going to force me to upgrade earlier would be the VRAM, because we are already getting games that don't like having 2 gig of VRAM, Forza Horizon again being one of them. I mean, it will run on a system with 2 gig of VRAM, but that's the problem. And now I knew that going into it. And as I said, as I've discussed with Skaz on many of occasions, did I, was the 1050 Ti worth 200 quid extra? Because we don't have any build to order options in the UK. And And at that point, it was because I managed to get a decent deal on this, at £800, that I went for this one in the end. And to be honest with you, I'm really happy with it. It's a nice laptop. It's just a shame that, in 2 or 3 years' time, the processor is still going to be fairly strong, unless there's a massive computational leap in the next couple of years, which, let's face it, if past trends be followed, I don't think there is going to be a massive leap. I mean, as I said, a 5-year-old Core i5 is pretty much able to run all the latest games. In fact, I believe there's only one or two games we've had a look at, but the Core i5 in Skaz's little burner box is slightly too weak to play. But then again, if he's got that much GPU, then it might make up for it. But for what he wants, that system is more than capable. And again, for very little outlay. I can see why. Well, you're gonna say, well, if you want upgradability, well, just buy a desktop. But for my case use, I want to just sit on the sofa like I'm doing now and play games. I can't really do that with a desktop PC. I'll have to go be confined to a corner of the house. And then for me, if I did that, the desktop PC would barely get any use. I had an iMac. When I left the Navy, it never got used. For me, the laptop is the perfect form factor. But unfortunately, it just seems to be, it's just a bit upsetting. But you can't upgrade it, and it does seem like a very wasteful platform. I mean, it's not a case of, oh, you're never going to be able to upgrade it, because I mean, oh, it's space, it's all less. I can understand ultrabooks being non-upgradable, but a big old gaming laptop like this, where you can dismantle the entire bottom and pull the components out, there's no reason why they can't make a modular graphics card, and even to a certain degree, a modular processor. I mean, obviously, processor, the motherboard generations would stop you being able to upgrade processor, but I mean, for the graphics card, I mean, what realistically, if we had like a modular graphics card, there would be no reason, little short of a PCI Express update, to prevent, the graphics card, a newer graphics card, working on an older motherboard. And in fact, even with PCI Express updates, older, newer graphics cards will run on older PCI Express slots, just albeit at a slower rate. I mean, obviously, you've got the option of an external GPU, but not all laptops support it. This one doesn't, because it doesn't have a Thunderbolt port. Again, to get a Thunderbolt port, you're already having to buy a machine that's well over the £1,000 mark. I mean, and obviously, don't get me started on UK pricing at the moment. Christ. I thought I got a good deal with this laptop, and in fact, in the UK, I did get a bloody good deal on this laptop. The problem is, the UK, we pay a lot extra for a lot of stuff. And so I got this laptop, which was an i5 7300 HQ, 8 GB of RAM, and a 4 a 2 GB GTX 1050 in America. And it's this review I saw on YouTube did piss me off when I saw it. HP have just released the Pavilion 15T. $699. That's dollars, which obviously is still, before Brexit completely ruins our currency, dollars are still worth less than pounds. So that computer is less than £699, and that 15T has the same i5. It's exactly the same spec as my laptop. It even looks the same, just a slightly different paint job. Mine's a black and red gamer aesthetic laptop, whereas the Pavilion is more just a grey business looking laptop. But the difference is, it has 4 GB of GDDR5. It's the same graphics card, the 1050, but it has 4 GB of DDR5. So Instantly, this laptop, which is not even a gamer-specific laptop, that laptop is a much higher spec. Well, I say much higher. It's a bit higher spec than mine, but it costs le a lot less. And then I was looking at the American HP site. In America, you can't actually buy an HP Omen anymore, like what I've got, with an i5. You only get the i7s. So, I thought Apple were the ones who are really bad for overcharging the UK. I figured the rest of the manufacturers were, they did jack up the prices, but I didn't think there would be, that much difference. But yeah, clearly, being in the UK is crap for laptops. I mean, as I said, we don't get any build to order options, so I couldn't have spec'd this up with a 1050 Ti for a little bit more. For me to get a 1050 Ti, as I've discussed in a previous video, I would have had to have paid 200 quid extra to get an i7 with it. So yeah, it's just a bit of a shame. Shame it, and it's all down to company greed, isn't it, really? At the end of the day, it's the big pound sign, the dollar sign. It's all greed. And it, as I said, it just, I'm not an environmentalist, and I'm not going to say, oh yeah, we need to bloody recycle our piss so we've got drinking water and shit like that. At the end of the day, I'm just a realist. The fact is, they keep bitching about e-waste, and the fact that we've got landfills full of oh Christ, I'm going to get smashed up by this wave, but we've got landfills full of old mobile phones and iPads and all that crap and laptops that can't be upgraded. And it's just piss poor, really. I mean, it's like the iPhones, and Android phones. It's planned obsolescence. The companies like Samsung, who you buy a 800 quid phone off them, and then literally, you get one update if you're lucky, and then that's it. You're having to flip in, get a whole new phone. And I know why the company, as I said, I know it's all down to the big profit and whatnot, but it just, it seems, it's all about profit, and they don't give a crap about customers. They're going on about, oh yeah, all our devices are highly recyclable, but the best way to recycle a device isn't to flip in just, send it to a recycling place to melt it down. The best way to recycle a device is being able to change some of the internal components to keep it up to date. At the end of the day, this i5 in here, paired up, in with the future, I don't know, 1150 or 1250 or whatever Nvidia end up calling them, will still be a fairly capable machine. I think that's enough of my rant for now. When I upload it to YouTube, if you want to have a few comments and debunk everything that I've said, then go for it. But at the end of the day, as I said, no, I just think we live in a very wasteful society, really. And if I didn't have a little girl to hand this down to, I'd be in the same position. 2, 3 years' time, I'm not able to play games that I want on it. I'd end up having to get rid of it. Would I keep it as a burner laptop? Would it just go into the cupboard under the stairs and got forgotten about? Would it be sold on eBay for a very? I wouldn't sell it on eBay, I think, in a couple of years, in a couple of years' time. If I didn't get a decent price for it, I wouldn't sell it. Because I'm the sort of person who likes to hold on to things. If I can't sell it for a decent price, then yeah, I won't sell it at all. I mean, testament to how well Apple hold their value and how well Apple of old used to be built. I've just recently sold a 2007 iMac to my friend, and I think they paid 150 quid for it, and their kids absolutely love it and use it every day. And that machine is, well, yeah, it's 10 years old this year, and it's still great. Again, that's another one what should have been able to be upgradable. But hey, Apple have gone even worse. You buy a laptop now, and you can't even upgrade the flipping RAM in it. So here's me bitching about HP and Dell for not making a flipping upgradable laptop, and flipping Apple, well, you're just getting complete planned obsolescence. You buy your new MacBook Pro, and unless you've got loads of money to begin with, You can't even spec your RAM up, because it's all bloody soldered down. I mean, Christ, Johnny Ive's quest for thinness has just taken the piss a bit, to be honest with you. I'd rather have a slightly thicker laptop, which I can crack open and put fucking massive, great big hard drive in it and load of RAM. But those new MacBooks, where they're all soldered down, you if you're not made of money to begin with, to spec the 1 terabyte SSD, and that's the other thing, because they don't allow rotary hard drives anymore. You have to go for really expensive SSDs. So, but yeah, Apple have lost me as a customer lately, to be honest with you. With their piss taking prices. I mean, the new iPhone is ridiculous. To get the new iPhone 7 in a similar configuration to what I've got in my iPhone 6s Plus, I would have to. Oh Christ, I'm dead. Bloody scout dickhead. Oh no, oh no, I'm all right. I survived. Aha, I survived. 1 second. Oh no, now I'm dead. Oh, talking of Scasius, there he is playing Portal. He keeps telling me to get Portal. I will do on payday. Oh crap, I died. Oh well. But Apple recently, one of the main reasons I actually got a gaming laptop in the first place was when Apple announced their MacBook Pros last year, and the astronomical price that they want for them, it got me looking around at other brands. What would I got from Dell or something? And when I saw that, and bear in mind this was when the day Apple announced their MacBook, so this is before the 1050 was available in laptops. I looked at Dell's website, and for I think at the time it was £949, I could have got the same quad core i7 that was in the MacBook in the 15-inch £2,000 MacBook, 128 gig SSD with 1 terabyte hard drive, and flipping, a GTX 960M, which is far better than all of the graphics cards on the MacBook up until like you get to the AMD issued ones. And and at that point I've seriously got looking at Windows laptops, because my MacBook has really annoyed me lately. Because I've had Macs of old which have looked like they've been through war-torn Kosovo and Afghanistan, holes in the external casing, everything, and they worked absolutely perfect. They were flawless. I got this new MacBook Pro a few years ago. It was the mid 2012 one, the one what had the seemingly infinite lifespan, because I think Apple sold it until about a couple of months ago. And I had that, and as I said, I've had it a couple of 3 years, and I've had no end of problems with it. The whole bottom of the case is all dented and just horrible looking, and it's hardly ever left the house. The hard drive, I thought the hard drive had packed in a couple of years ago, and it turns out the hard drive is absolutely fine. In fact, the hard drive is now attached to my Wii with Wii backups on it. Basically, what had happened was is the ribbon cable, what connects the hard drive to the motherboard inside it, had broken. What it looked like is a load of dirt and crap had got into a seemingly sealed laptop somehow. It looked like I'd gone to the beach, buried it, and then dug it out a week later. And little bits of dirt and grit had eaten away at the hard drive cable. So the hard drive gave the illusion of failing because it was still loading up, but just a bit slower at some points. And in the end, I bought a whole new hard drive thinking it was that, and then suddenly that didn't fix it. And so then I did a bit of research, and yeah, it turned out the ribbon cable was a known issue since the 2009 models. Yet in the 2012 model, they still hadn't replaced it. The DVD drive as well. The DVD drive hasn't worked in it in about a. I hardly used the DVD drive, to be honest with you. And the DVD drive hasn't worked in it in the last year and a half. And Apple's recent build quality has really put me off buying their products anymore. I had an iPhone 6, and I don't wear tight skinny jeans. You know, I love baggy clothes. I always wear baggy clothes. The phone has always been in a case in my pocket. No, you know, never gone naked. You know, it's always been in a case, and it still somehow suffered the bending issue. When I called the insurance on the phone to say, "Look, my phone's broken," they turned around and went, "Oh no, it's because it's bend gate. We're not going to pay out. You need to contact Apple. Apple need to pay out." I contacted Apple. "Oh no, it's bent. It's out of warranty." So I was left up shit creek without a paddle with a phone which looked like a banana. I mean, thankfully it held on for a while, and in the end, O2 offered me an early upgrade, and I took the iPhone 6s Plus because at the time this was, they were expensive, but they weren't ludicrously priced like the new 7s. And in the end, the old 6 I used as a second phone and I put my work SIM card in it. And then suddenly one day I find that it ain't connecting to the mobile network. And it's now that useless. It doesn't function as a phone. My little girl uses it as a mini Wi-Fi only iPad. And I mean, I've never had an iPhone which is broken quite like that. You know, my original first generation iPhone, which was handed down to me by my dad, because he got it from America, and then I swapped him it for a Windows phone at the time because my Windows phone at the time had TomTom on it. So I then had the original iPhone for a good year or so. Then I handed it down to my wife, who then had it for a year or so, and then she then handed it down to her dad, and he had it for a good few years. It's actually only recently been swapped out because the battery had completely died on it. And that phone, you know, it still turns on and works. You know, they just don't build things like they used to anymore. Things just aren't built to last. You know, they shave a millimeter off it here, shave a millimeter off it there. Ooh, everyone wants thinness, you know. No, I don't want thinness. I'd rather have a slightly thicker laptop, but one I can crack open, put my own massive hard drive in, new RAM, and put a thicker battery in it, and then that way you don't have that problem where the battery's dying ridiculously quick and not meeting your flipping expectations. Then you're having to tell the reviewers, "Oh no, you're reviewing it wrong." Fucking hell. And that is one of the reason why I am slowly cutting my ties with Apple. I mean, as I said, I paid £800 for this laptop, and in terms of raw performance, it ships all over anything Apple makes up to £2,000. Because, I mean, their 13-inch MacBook Pros with a touch bar are only dual-core i5s. This is a quad-core i5, so I've got two more flipping physical cores. You know, I've got the same 8 gig. I've got the same DDR4, 8 gig of RAM, same memory clock speed. The only thing the Apples have got better than this are a much nicer screen. Okay, they look a bit nicer. Battery lasts a bit longer, the screen, the battery, and the looks really, and oh yeah, and the super far and their NVMe SSDs. But if I wanted to pay a few quid, I could actually stick an NVMe 1 gigabyte transfer rate SSD in this laptop. The SSD I've got in here is only a 500 read 180 write because it's a small 128. But if I wanted to, I could crack this open, and I do believe it supports an NVMe drive, which would give me Apple level read writes. So, you know, for less than half the price of the 13-inch MacBook Pro with touch bar, I've got a machine that is far more powerful than it. And in most cases, it would probably almost keep up with the 15-inch MacBook Pro, you know, especially with graphics, because the top-end MacBook Pro has only got the RX 460 in it, a laptop equivalent of the RX 460. And the GTX 1050 that I've got in here is actually rated, you know, it tests better than the RX 460 in benchmark tests. So, yeah, I don't know, it's just Apple and their Apple tax. You know, I remember a few years ago, you know, Apple computers weren't massively expensive. Yes, they were expensive, but we compare them to laptops of back in the day, and you were only paying 100 or so more for equivalent performance in Mac versus Windows. And generally, the Macs were far better built. The Windows computers back when I switched to Mac were all plastic monstrosities, which were nasty and everything else. The Macs were generally well built, but at the end of the day, when the Windows side's caught up, Windows 10 is actually quite a nice operating system. And I have to admit, after using this system for a while, I went back and used the MacBook Pro the other day. And I don't know if it's just because it's only a 720p screen or, but OS X just felt old. It felt like dated. And, I would never have said, I would never have had a bad thing to say about Apple before. I was the biggest Apple fan going. I bought my PowerBook G3 back in 2005 off eBay. And then, I never looked back, really, to be honest with you. It was a brilliant machine. And then I had the G4, and then I got a MacBook, and then I've got the MacBook Pro. But yeah, and as you can see, this is a bit of a just a random rant. I just fill the time streaming. I'll stick this on YouTube at some point. As I said, if you want to comment and leave comments in the comments below and completely disagree with everything I say, then that's the power of the internet. It's democracy. We can disagree with people. But yeah, upgradable laptops. There needs to be a laptop upgradable graphics card. Manufacturers need to come together and create a sort of mobile PCI Express slot. The graphics card is a little tiny square chip. How hard is it to put a like a universal connector on the end of it? Literally, you open up your laptop, lift up the heat pipes, flip in, install your graphics card with your, I don't know, mobile PCI Express slot, bit of thermal paste on it, lob your heat pipes back on the top, bang, job's done. There's no reason realistically why we can't have that technology. The only reason preventing us from having that technology is just pure greed. Profit, 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 greed, greed, greed. Oh, I better repair the jackdaw, actually. Look at this. I've lost all me. Here we go. The pirate in the seven seas. Do, 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 do. Oh, Christ, I didn't repair it enough, though. Oh shit, and there's a man o' war there as well. That fucker's a beast. Oh Christ. Let's get the hell out of here. Oh, run away! I'm gonna get smashed up! I have to admit, this Black Flag is a nice looking game. I mean, it isn't running as smooth as it has done purely because I'm streaming in the background. And this isn't even maxed out. This is 1080p, but I'm running only high textures rather than very high. I'm just running on what the Nvidia experience says I should be running it at. So I haven't faffed with any of the settings. I played it and completed it on this settings, and to be honest with you, it looks beautiful. To think there's you can turn settings up on it. It's pretty impressive, to be honest with you. And as I said, this is running on what is effectively base model hardware. I mean, yes, all right, it's an old game. It's an old game now. What is it, 2013? Oh, Christ, here we go. Got hit by a wave, and my ship's going to get smashed up. Run away! Oh, Christ, I need to go get some more crew. But yeah, so yeah, this was my little rant about why aren't there upgradable laptops? So I'm just gonna finish the stream now, and I'll upload it to YouTube. All right, ciao for now. Christ, yeah, let me exit the game, then I can finish the stream.